I'm Janina, a senior at Curie High School. Tonight is Morgan Park versus Curie for the Chicago Public League title.
It's the best basketball in the city.
It's the game of the week on the U2.
Welcome everybody to Chicago State University for the 2019 CPS Boys Championship game. It is Morgan Park against Curie. Welcome everybody, I'm Jim Blaney. Thank you so much for joining us for what may be the hardest championship to win in boys high school basketball, the CPS title. Morgan Park is trying to win their first championship since 2010. Curie was a winner in this game in 2014. They're trying to put the trophy in their cabinet for the first time. Joining me for today are my partners. To my left, Kenny McReynolds, and to my right, Rick Malnati. And Rick, let's talk about Morgan Park. They are on a roll. They figured things out in mid-December, and they've been rolling ever since. They've got one of the best players in the state in Adam Miller, but the fact of the matter is, this is a very balanced team.
Well, they do have a great team, but the straw that stirs the drink is Adam Miller. He's a big-bodied guard. He's ranked like the top 20 in the country. To get him into the finals, he had to score 30, and he scored 26 of those in the second half.
Meanwhile, going the other way, Kenny, about Curie, this might be the quietest number one team that we've ever seen. There's not a lot of people talking about it. They're talking about Morgan Park. They're talking about the struggle that Simeon had. Can Whitney Young win it all? But yet here is Curie behind DeJuan Gordon with a chance, and a great chance, to win a CPS title.
Yeah, and they want to win their first CPS title. Curie's ranked number one, I think, because of Gordon. He's their guard. He scored 23 points against Orr in his semifinals. He's going to lead this team, Jim, both on the offense and defensive end. If the Condors are to win their first CPS championship, because the other one was vacated, Gordon will have to play a big role today.
And one more thing about Curie, too. They have been a number one seed in the state tournament for basically half a decade, so they sometimes get overlooked. Meanwhile, Morgan Park, they've been racking up and putting state trophies in their cabinet, but the one everybody really wants is the CPS title, and we will decide it today. When we come back, we'll get it started. It's Morgan Park and Curie in the 2019 CPS Boys title game coming up next on the Game of the Week on the U2. Tonight's game is brought to you by Robert Morris University. Experience makes experts. Experts make a difference. Jim Blaney, Rick Malnati, Kenny McReynolds, ready for the game tonight. And we also have Mark Kruger with us as well. Mark?
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Well, I cannot think of two teams that are playing better basketball right now than Curie and Morgan Park, as we bring in Michael O'Brien of the Chicago Sun-Times. And Michael, your thoughts, your expectations of this championship game?
Boy, like you said, I can't remember a time when the teams were so hot going at one another. I think Curie needs to play their normal game to win. They've been dominant this year. Only one team, Simeon, has come within single digits of them. Morgan Park needs a big game from star junior Adam Miller.
Let's bring in your top 25. Of course, we see the Curie Condors at number one, and Morgan Park, there you see them at number three. Now, after this game, the IHSA state tournament is where everybody's going to be focused on. Morgan Park in Class 3A, Curie in Class 4A. If either one of those teams do not get to Peoria, would you be surprised?
I'd be very surprised if Morgan Park doesn't get there. They do have a big test against Bogan. They'd have to beat them again. But Curie, it's a meat grinder getting through that sectional and super sectional, so it wouldn't be a shock.
Now, if you had to vote today for Illinois' Mr. Basketball, who would you vote for?
Mr. Basketball is probably a clear winner, E.J. Liddell down in Belleville West. Our Player of the Year, which is just the Sun-Times coverage area, though, really tough. Today is going to determine an awful lot. DeJuan Gordon or Adam Miller seem to be the top two candidates.
All right, going to put you on the spot here. prediction time. Who is going to win tonight and why?
I think you have to pick Curie. They've had a dominant season, haven't lost to anybody in the state. One of the best seasons we've seen in a long time. And they, as I said before, just have to play their normal game to win. They're a great team, a great core of five guys together.
How about the state championship? Do you think one of these two teams, Curie or Morgan Park, going to win it all?
Yeah, I think Morgan Park's the favorite in 3A. I'd be surprised if they didn't. I think Curie can win it, but it's going to be a lot tougher for them.
Michael O'Brien, we appreciate you stopping by. I have to get your final thoughts, though, on the CPS teams this year. It seems like the talent level is just above and beyond everything else in recent years.
Yeah, or could win Class 2A as well. They could get a sweep. The CPS has dominated the suburbs this year. Like, I can't remember before. There's no doubt about that.
Let you enjoy the game. Thanks for stopping by.
It'll be fun. Thanks, Mark.
All right, Jim, back over to you.
All right, Mark, thank you very much. Just to amplify what Michael O'Brien and Mark were talking about, Curie, the closest anybody has gotten to beating them among Illinois teams. Simeon fell by 7 back on November 29th. That was in the Pontiac tournament. And then Bogan lost by 8 back on January 8th. For a little reference for Morgan Park, their last loss was January 24th to Simeon. That was 70-52. And then Curie and Morgan Park met back on December 11th. A game Curie won 94-62. It is time now for our national anthem. As Willy Wonka said, let me strike something and reverse it. The game back on January 24th, Morgan Park won that game 70-52. So it's a 22-game winning streak for Morgan Park as they come into this game. Morgan Park, as I mentioned, is trying to win their first CPS title since 2010. Remember that one, Kenny?
Blackshear.
Wayne Blackshear at the buzzer against Marshall.
Yep.
And what I remember best is we were at the UIC Pavilion. Morgan Park had the ball last, and everybody on the floor went to one side, and Wayne Blackshear got the basketball, and Morgan Park won that game by a point as Blackshear hit the buzzer.
Yeah, and I remember Rick Pitino going crazy in the pavilion that night.
It was an amazing performance by Wayne Blackshear that night.
But it's not like they're not short on championships. They've won other championships in the last few years.
They were CPS champions in 2001, 1976, and 1974. So they are familiar with winning CPS titles at Morgan Park. But I was kind of surprised that it's been 9 years since they've won one. And they have a great chance tonight. There's a look at Adam Miller, who every time you watch him, he just amazes you with his ability and his calmness, I think, because one of the things I really like about him best.
Well, he is really doing a great job, not only getting his, but making sure others on his team get theirs. He is really distributing the ball well. I think that's the best improvement he made from his sophomore to junior year is that.
The Curie Condors, they are making their first CPS title game appearance since 2014. This is their third appearance since 2012. They lost that game in 2012, They won the game in 2014, but Kenny, as you mentioned, they had to vacate that title. So they essentially tonight are playing for their first ever CPS title.
Yeah, and they really want to win that CPS title, Jeff, because they remember the hard work it took to get here in 14. They didn't have a chance to keep it. They want to win it today. They've only lost one game all year, and they have been on a roll. And when the brackets came out, we said this would probably be the matchup everybody wanted to see. I think the best two teams, Coach, are here today.
But when the current Curie seniors were freshmen, Curie won the state 4A title. So they know, and they've been around to see the Curie Condors win big games. Sean Washington, also in the starting lineup for Morgan Park. We saw him absolutely light it up against Simeon at Simeon High School back about, what, 3 weeks ago, Kenny? And meanwhile, for Curie, it is just a balanced team that can hurt you in a lot of different ways.
Yeah, you know what? They don't have the one guy scoring 40 points a game and the McDonald's All-American. They just have one really good team and one excellent coach in Mike Oliver.
Michael Oliver always has his team in it, and I mentioned they have been ranked number one for most of the year, but I think if you would have asked people who's the number one team in the Chicagoland area, according to the Sun-Times, they would guess Whitney Young, they would guess Morgan Park. Well, it's been Curie for most of the year.
Yep.
And they do have a Player of the Year candidate, DeJuan Gordon. I mean, the kid is versatile. He does a little bit of everything. His stats don't jump out at you, but I'll tell you what, sometimes the guy that makes everybody better is the guy that should win that Player of the Year.
Carl Jones wins the opening tip, and it's Sean Washington that cleans it up and puts it away.
Boy, that didn't take long. Washington crashed the boards.
And that's where Morgan Park really has to be effective, is going to the offensive boards. That's a little bit where Curie's got a weakness, if they have a weakness. Nobody's beat them in the state of Illinois so far this year.
Their only loss of the year came to Salesian Prep from California. That was back on January 4th. That was a 6-point loss by the Condors.
Boy, look at this defense.
They're really getting after it.
Drive to the basket, Trevon Hamilton. He gave it away. There was a jersey grab on the way to the basket. That was a champion jersey grab too, folks.
Well, that's one way. That's one way to stop your guy from getting by you.
Carl Jones picks up the foul, so a trip to the foul line for Justin Harmon early, and he'll have a chance to tie the game.
I think you're going to see both teams really dig it on defense. Both teams can play on the half court. Both teams can play on the full court.
It's a good look at Nick Urban and state championships, 13, 14, 17, 18.
He's running out of room on that shirt to put all the state championships.
A lot of trophies in that trophy case.
Second free throw missed, but Hamilton with the rebound for Curie. So a chance to take the lead for the Condors. In the corner, three-pointer on the way. That'll be short, and the rebound pulled down by Adam Miller. Morgan Park moves the ball nicely up the court. Miller, his first touch on offense. He'll drive, he'll stop. Little 12-foot runner off the back of the iron. And that was tipped out and last touch by Morgan Park's Sean Washington. And the Condors will get it. Michael Oliver, well, 28-1. What else do you need to say? And a great resume. They have been a number one seed in the state playoffs now for 5 out of the last 6 years. In the only year in recent years they weren't a number one, they were a number five. So they're always up in the upper echelon of Illinois high school basketball.
Here goes Morgan Park switching defenses already. They're into his zone.
Yeah, they're going to come out in his zone. Oh, wide open.
And that's going to be a goaltend called, so we are going to give the basket to Gordon.
Trevon Hamilton with a great look over the top. That is one kid that's played all 4 years for Coach Oliver.
Let's go to Mark Kruger.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. I did talk to Coach Mike Oliver before the ball game. I asked him how his team was going to defend Adam Miller. He said they were going to start out in a 1-2-2 zone and then go man-to-man and just throw fresh bodies at him all night long, mixing things up defensively. We'll see how it goes, Jim.
All right, you better get a guy on Sean Washington, too, because he scored the first 5 points of the game for Morgan Park.
He's one of the reasons they got 22 straight. He's really come on strong, really a great scorer. Long on defense, he's doing a little bit of everything for Nick Urban.
I have to be honest, back on Martin Luther King Day, when we saw them play Bolingbrook, I don't remember a lot of what Sean Washington did. But in the game against Simeon, he was outstanding. Underneath, Gordon knocks another one in.
Great defense by Damari Nixon.
Yeah, you know what? Gordon had that knack for being around in basketball.
It's Marcus Watson for Morgan Park.
Now they're playing a box and one, well, face guard Miller.
Well, I think Miller's going to see every defense you can think of. Box and one, regular zone, triangle and two.
Who'd they call that foul on?
That I did not see.
Yeah, it might be Washington. We have a really hard time here at Chicago State because the referees point the opposite direction to signal the fouls, and they don't put the fouls on the board. So I saw the referee hold up a four, so it's either Miller or Washington. I'm going to go with Washington right now.
So do you go zone out of bounds?
Yeah, they're staying zone.
Game tied at five, and an errant pass onto the low block. It was intended for Burrell. Turnover by the Mustangs. Condors get it.
Well, unforced turnovers, those are the ones that would drive coaches crazy.
Curie beat Orr in the semifinals, 63-52. Morgan Park beat Simeon, 71-68, to get to this championship game. And that'll be tipped away by Adam Miller. The pass was intended for Ramin Hinton.
Morgan Park is so long in that zone, it's really hard to make passes unless they're really crisp. Curie's going to have to get into the middle somehow, either with the pass or with the dribble.
Tamari Nixon will inbound for Simeon, or for Curie.
Why did Tamari run into a corner after he inbounded?
And he did exactly that. Didn't get the return pass, though. Into the corner. Jumper on the way from Hinton. That was tipped on the way to the basket.
Well, I'm not sure I've ever seen that.
That was odd looking. Yeah. That looked like a shot, but it wasn't going in.
And his teammate thought it was a pass because he went up to try and dunk that.
This is a strange one, folks.
Watch the shot. Now, look, he goes up, and then he'll try to tip it right in.
Yeah.
It's pretty odd. That was Owens trying to tip it in.
Adam Miller on the other end with a free throw line jumper.
Both teams trying to feel each other out still. We haven't gotten a lot of momentum going.
Foul was on Gordon, his first. Miller goes to the line. Well, you show me a guy who racks up a lot of points, I'll show you guys a pretty good free throw shooter, and Miller is exactly that.
And Miller knows exactly how to get to the line.
We invoked the name Wayne Blackshear earlier. I think for Nick Irvin, this is the next guy in that recent years, Billy Garrett Jr. and Blackshear and the D1 guys.
Io.
Yeah, Sulu. Io down in Illinois. Yes.
Boy, is he having a great year or what?
He's Illinois' best player.
I think that Illinois, they used to do that I-L-L-I, they're going A-Y-O-I-N-I now.
And how about, if you just take what U of I has done in the last month.
Yeah, he's really
they're one of the better teams in the Big Ten.
And they're young.
They're only going to get better.
He can make
long three-pointer. That one rattles out by Damari Nixon. How do you know that, Rick, that he can make that?
Yeah,
you know a little bit about it.
Nice pass.
Nice pass. Nice drive on the baseline as well. And that's finished off by Kyle Grover, another guy who, don't go to sleep on him. He can get it going as well, yeah, even though he's mainly known as a great defensive player.
Yeah, I like that nice bounce pass by Watson.
Four-point lead for Morgan Park. Three-pointer missed. Adam Miller. He plays a little defense, too, by the way, folks.
He's always around the basketball.
Morgan Park being a little bit patient. We're midway through the first quarter. The Mustangs have a four-point lead. Miller stops. Long three. Got it.
See, that's his range.
Yeah, that's not long for him.
We've
seen him shoot from almost half court.
Yeah, I mean, he'll put him up. He's not bashful.
3:41 to go, and Morgan Park already out to a seven-point lead. Condors need to get something going.
We got to penetrate a little bit. Hamilton's got to get in the lane. There he goes.
Into the lane, passes out. Harmon. Boy, look at the defense by Morgan Park. They recover nicely. Missed three. No
call. The layup.
Up the floor. Grover, what a catch. He did not travel, and he got it to roll in.
He's a football player. You can tell it there like a wide receiver.
Great hands, great catch.
Michael Oliver calls a timeout. Morgan Park jumps out to a 9-point first quarter lead.
We talk about those early leads being fool's gold, but Curie has not been behind a lot all year.
That catch was as good as anything you'll see out of Odell Beckham Jr.
I I think that catch may be as good as anything you see out of anybody. That was one great catch.
Time now for our move of the quarter. It is brought to you by Robert Morris University. And Kenny, it's a great catch.
Well, I mean, it was a great pass too, but the catch was just unbelievable.
He caught that thing. Watch as he catches it on his fingertips.
Right there. And he gets control of the basketball as the coach and lays it in without traveling.
I'm liking what Kenny said. That was an unbelievable pass.
Yeah, the pass was pretty
good. Yeah, Adam Miller put that down. That was a dime. Never dribbled, looked up. I mean, that's why the kid's ranked 20th in the country.
Nobody throws a deep ball better than Adam Miller except for Ben Roethlisberger.
And our move of the quarter was brought to you by Robert Morris.
At the foul line. Condors really got to get something going. Harmon had nothing to work with. The defense for Morgan Park is suffocating, nearly a turnover again. Hamilton works his way in. Couldn't hit the shot. Attempted the dunk by Gordon off the rebound, and here comes Morgan Park again. Grover had it stripped away. That'll be a foul on Damari Nixon.
I think that's a shooting foul.
It looked like he was going to lay up. Yeah.
I don't know if they're going to give it to him, but I think that was.
Nope, they're not. But watch the inbound guy.
Well, if it's Adam Miller.
Washington wide open. He has to take that. He'll knock it in. Boy, 2 3-pointers for Sean Washington so far.
Boy, I tell you what. He has picked a great time to start heating up the last month of the season. He's been unbelievable.
Kenny, you shocked by this?
No.
Rick?
I am. I am a little shocked by this. I think Curry's going to get back in the game, but I didn't think Morgan Park was going to get off to such a great start.
Well, they've been on such a great roll, and here they do again on defense.
This time it's Marcus Watson, and he'll put it in.
See, they're doing this on the defensive end.
Yes, Kenny, I was thinking the exact same thing.
They're not doing it on the offensive end. They're doing this on the defensive end.
And they're open threes, but, you know, it's a time where Curry doesn't want to burn a timeout, but they might need another timeout. This is where you need your captain, Hamilton, to make a play. Just get inside.
14-0 run, and off the end line, and it should have gone off of Washington. It did. Curie will keep it. It was 5-5, and since then, Curie has not scored.
Yeah, if you're Mike Oliver right now, you're a little bit uncomfortable. You want to see something go in. You want to get one of your players off. These passes got to be a little crisper.
Three-pointer, Gordon stops the run.
And that's the guy you want to make a basket to if you're Oliver. That's what he needed there.
But, yeah, you need your best player
to
decide
what to do.
Yeah,
that saved him a timeout.
Gordon has 7 of the 8 Curie points. Morgan Park is going to make Curie chase a little bit and open up the floor. Miller and Washington, both of them red hot right now, outworking the points.
Curry going man-to-man right now.
Washington drives, bounce pass, that was picked off. Hinton came up with it, and now Hamilton up the floor.
It's a chance to be the first time you make back-to-back baskets if you're Curry. You got to take advantage of that turnover.
Gordon fouled by Watson. That is team foul number 3 on Morgan Park. Marcus Watson will come out of the game. Christian Roberts will come in for Morgan Park.
And Roberts is instant offense.
Hamilton, a little tall. Nixon caught it.
That's it.
Free throw line feed, fall away jumper, and Hinton couldn't hit it, but he's going to get a chance to go to the line.
That's where you got to get the ball, though, right there in the middle at the free throw line. Hinton knew what to do. You know, Hinton's their star in waiting right now as a junior.
Isaiah Burrell picks up the foul.
We haven't seen a lot of Carl Jones yet today.
At all?
No.
Yeah.
He won the opening tip.
Back in the old days, in the very old days, when they jumped every, you know, you need a guy like that.
Yeah.
Every basket, you have a jump off.
Elijah Pickens will come in for Curie. By the way, you look back on the history of basketball, whoever decided to get rid of the tip after every basket, that was a great decision.
Yeah. I think it was a guy that had a short center.
And that one spins around and out.
They needed those two.
Curie, 1 out of 4 from the foul line.
They're running 2 at Miller, trying to get the ball out of his hands.
He's used to that. backing in. Roberts, fall away. He couldn't hit. Tipped out. Miller got it. 36 seconds to go. Here's Washington in the corner. Roberts, what an explosive first step, huh?
Boy.
So fast.
Yeah, but you know what? Give Adam Miller a lot of credit. He was poised. He saw the double team coming. He passes out of the double team.
Good fired inside Pickett. And unable to hit the basket was Hinton got his own rebound and able to muscle it in.
Now you got to run two people at Miller because you can't let him get the last shot with 10 seconds to go in the quarter.
Hinton becomes the first Condor to hit a field goal other than Gordon. Miller rolls, throws it up, can't get it. Rebound, and they won't get a shot off before the buzzer goes. A clinic on defense by Morgan Park to start this game out. End of one. Morgan Park leads it over Curie, 21-10. You're watching the CPS title game on the Game of the Week on the YouTube. Tonight's game is brought to you by the contractors of finishingchicago.com. For Morgan Park, Sean Washington, and Adam Miller, they combine for 13 points in that opening quarter, and Kenny, it was bombs away. They did it by making three threes. Morgan Park, they took three threes, they made all three of them.
Yeah, you see Washington there, then here comes Mr. Miller. As we always like to say, welcome to Miller time. This young man is special. And then again, you swing it back out, and another three-pointer there by Washington. The Mustangs doing a great job so far.
So how does
in their huddle.
How does Nick Irvin keep his guys, keep up the intensity on defense and not look at the scoreboard and say, hey, look how great we're doing?
Well, that's a challenge, right? That's a challenge. And you know, Curry's not 28-1 for, you know, they're 28-1 for a reason. These guys play. They play hard. They share the ball. They're used to winning. They're going to make a run.
Oh, yeah. And there's a lot of basketball to be played. This game isn't over by any means of the imagination.
The problem that Curie has had has been moving the ball quick enough to not let the double team get on top of them.
Yeah, and maybe screening the zone a little bit and penetrating a little bit. You know, Hamilton's got to get inside and make other people better.
Three-pointer, two-pointer. Knocked down from the corner by Gordon. So they did the one first thing they needed to do, make sure you score coming out of the break. Top of the key, a collision, and that is going to be an illegal screen called against Morgan Park. And the foul is going to be on Christian Roberts. Well, there was no way anybody was set on that.
Right.
That was just a train wreck up there at the top of the key.
It was a dribble handoff that just went awry.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't really a screen.
Watch this.
Yeah. Ooh. Ooh.
Yeah, it was two guys just ran into each other. But if you're an offensive man, theoretically you're supposed to be set.
And if it's 21-12 and you want a close game, let's go the other way.
Spoken like a true coach.
As a coach, you always feel like the calls go against you when you have a lead.
Exactly, and that one will rattle off. And Burrell had a hand on the rebound, but he had inside position and was hit from behind.
That's a big time rebound by Burrell, as he explodes off his feet going for the offensive board, and he comes down with a man on his back.
Well, it looks like Curry in the quarter talked about, let's pressure. Let's get up here and let's pressure full court. And it's hard to pressure Morgan Park. Watson's a terrific guard.
That foul was on Harmon, by the way, and Grover is back into the game for Morgan Park. Burrell, free throw line, turned it over. Here comes Hamilton the other way. On the run, the Condor is able to get two.
And they needed an easy basket.
Yeah, and hit the run we talked about.
Exactly. They got to try and get a couple back-to-back here, try and turn them over again.
4-0 run to open up the second quarter by Curie. Adam Miller turns, fires, and cannot hit. Rebound pulled down by Hinton.
And Curry's going to be a lot more effective when they don't let Morgan Park set up their defense.
Gordon knocks down his second three of the night, and it's down to a four-point margin. Timeout, Morgan Park.
And how about DeJuan Gordon making a run at Player of the Year the way he's playing?
And let's go to Mark Krueger.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Well, Curie hitting the three-pointer here tonight. You know, you go back to that December 11th meeting when Curie won 94-62. Curie with four players in double figures. They shot, get this, Jim, 10 of 14 from behind the arc. They were 24 of 26 from the foul line. So they got it done shooting the ball back on December 11th. We'll see how well they shoot tonight, Jim.
Mark, thank you so much. Great crowd on hand. They're starting to go sit in the upper tank here at Chicago State. And huge basket right here, guys, as they bring it down the floor. Curie works it into the corner. DeJuan Gordon wide open and does not miss.
Well, and that's, you know, Morgan Park not having a chance to set up their defense. Curry's really struggled when Morgan Park's been able to set up their zone defense.
4-point lead for Morgan Park. It was 11 at the break. At one time it was 14, and they turn it over again.
Another unforced turnover, Coach.
The only guy that was open was Jeff Corbett.
And he couldn't handle it.
Chance for Curie to make it a one-possession game. Hamilton says, everybody, calm down. Let's run in the half court. Let's make sure we get a good shot. Yeah, I do too. Baseline drive, and that is going to be a foul on Carl Jones.
It's a great job by DeJuan Jordan getting to the rim, but all created by Hamilton's dribble penetration.
Well, I like the way they came down court. Hey, let's calm down, guys. Let's not hurry. We have the momentum going. They didn't just come down and get all wrapped up in the crowd.
Well, one thing about Gordon is you got to run out at him and react to his three-point shooting ability because he's such a good shooter. And then he's got the ability to put the ball on the ground and get to the rim.
So after that second personal foul, Kenny, Jones goes out, Burrell comes back in. Gordon made the first free throw. Only the second made free throw by Curie in the game. That one in and out. Adam Miller makes the rebound, and it is a one-possession game. It's 21-18 right now, Morgan Park. Offensive foul, Adam Miller. Curie with a chance to tie it up.
Armand Williams giving him great minutes off the bench. He's changed the game defensively.
Boy, watch this one. He looks like he loses his balance right there. A little push off.
And he sold it.
Yep. But it was a push off.
Remember Rick McLeish of the Philadelphia Flyers way back in the 70s? One of the all-time great divers that ever lived. That was a Rick McLeish type of dive. Three-pointer ties it.
Curry guard's got to penetrate.
That's for the tie. A little short. Nice rebound, stick back wouldn't go, batted around, and we are going to get a two-shot foul called against Kyle Grover of Morgan Park.
Boy, Morgan Park, what a drought. They haven't scored this quarter.
And just look at their body language, how it changed from the beginning of the game.
Boy, look at the rebound. What an outstanding rebound going strong to the basket with Gordon.
That's where Carl Jones in foul trouble hurts Morgan Park because he's going to clean up most of those missed shots.
Gordon hits the first, has one more coming as Nick Irvin's team has seen a 14-point lead shrink to two, maybe to one.
And Gordon offensively, single-handedly, is, you know, putting Curie over the top.
He has 15 of the Curie 20 points. It is a one-point game, Curie with the press. Washington into the front court. Little handoff to Marcus Watson. Watson has a screen from Miller and then the switch nicely by the Curie defense.
Yeah, I think Morgan Park's just got to go around some people. They're just playing up front, trying to post people up. They just got
travel called on Watson, and Curie has a chance to take the lead after a timeout from Nick Irvin, and Nick is going to go talk to the official.
And again, it's Armand Williams on the ball, creating havoc, just putting great pressure on the ball, changing the game with his defensive energy.
I didn't see the travel.
Neither did I.
Yeah, that may be a phantom travel there, but again, like you said, Coach, you got Williams on the ball. Williams has done a tremendous job dominating this basketball game on the defensive end. He doesn't have to score, but he has changed the complexion of this game with his defense.
And that's the one thing about Curie. They go 7-8 deep, and everybody knows their role, and when they come in, they are the best at their role as they can be. And Williams' job is to give them energy off the bench.
Well, if this were the old CBA, you would have Morgan Park winning the first quarter, and you have Curie ahead here in the second quarter.
Well, this is going to be a great game. I don't think anybody's going to blow anybody out.
Yeah, you might want to keep that fan handy because the intensity is ratcheting up in here.
You know, it is hot in here.
Bob Marleymont.
I tell you what, the upper deck is getting a lot of people
put
up there now.
More and more people going up there all the time. A little late, but it's okay.
But it took a while to get in.
Little runner, and the Condors come back and take the lead on a runner by Elijah Pickens.
This is unbelievable.
And they're starting to feel a lot more comfortable.
Washington fires it in the corner. Grover wide open to Marcus Watson.
Wow.
Blocking foul. And that is going to be on, that'll be on Armond Williams, his first.
But again, Armond Williams in the middle, in the thick of defensive effort.
That's a
good call.
He had that left foot up in the air and was still sliding.
And Morgan Park needed a basket.
In the worst way.
It's only the second trip to the foul line in the game for Morgan Park. Miller hit 2 out of 2 when he got to the line earlier. Watson hits, and Morgan Park off of the three-point play. They take a one-point lead. Excuse me, a two-point lead. Back and forth we go now, I guess, for a little while. Baseline jumper, that's knocked in by Hinton.
And again, I love the bounce pass. Jim, for years, you've always heard me talk about bounce pass. That's the only way that ball would get there.
Now we have the game we expected.
Yes. Clear out for Miller.
Burrell showing the open hand away from the man, but Watson chose to rebalance the floor.
Morgan Park struggling a little bit in the half court executing what they want to execute.
Kyle Grover gets up in the air and then got pushed by Justin Harmon. That'll be the second on Harmon. And that is team foul number 6.
Curry's pushed Curie. Morgan Park all the way to half court to initiate the offense. You know, you talk as a coach about you winning the battle of the catch and the battle of entry in your offense. And right now, Curry's winning that battle, making Morgan Park start their offense from way out on the court. It's a lot harder.
Morgan Park, as a team right now, they are 4 for 4 from the line. You see Pickens go out and Damari Nixon come back in.
Well, that can be crucial at the end of the ballgame if you can make your free throws.
And both teams are in the bonus right now, so expect some more free throws to be shot the rest of the way.
6 of 6 for Morgan Park. And they are up by 1. Well, that's what I get for looking at the scoreboard in here and not trusting our guys in the truck. It's a 2-point lead. At least the clock is ticking properly. That's a plus.
Yeah.
3:19 to go here in the second quarter, and whistle away from the ball, and the foul will be on Morgan Park, and that is on Burrell, and that is his second.
Yeah, for some reason, the whistles are not really loud when they're blowing the whistle. See, we could hardly hear it, but the players heard it, and that's why they stopped.
Chris Roberts comes back into the game for Morgan Park. Burrell will go to the bench after that second foul.
You know, talking to Coach Oliver, Trevon Hamilton has a 7-to-1 turnover to assist ratio. You just do not ever see that.
No.
And also, he was the only kid that played on their state championship team 4 years ago. He's been playing since he's been a freshman. So moments like this are never going to be too big for him.
Roberts turned it over to Gordon. Armbar by Hamilton, didn't get called. Inside the lane, that one won't go. And through a sea of arms, it ends up in the hands of Kyle Grover, and he lays it in.
And that's what the Mustangs want to do. They want to get in transition.
That's
they'd
where
love
they've
to
been
run.
Their best.
Yeah.
Morgan Park up by 4. We're inside of 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Morgan Park fell behind, but now has surged back out in front. Three-point in front of the iron, no good. And that was saved off of the end line. We're going to get a foul call on Morgan Park.
Yeah, Damari Nixon did a great job going to get that ball and trying to tap it back in. He must have gotten fouled when he came down.
Well, he did a great job, though, going for that ball. I mean, he went for that loose ball.
And if Curie doesn't come up with the offensive rebounds, they wind up giving up layups on the other end. As long as they score, they're okay. They got their transition defense on misses has to improve. I'm sure that's one thing Coach will talk about at halftime.
Damari Nixon on the line. That was the second foul on Roberts. Nixon hits. Nixon, in his younger days, he was, along with his brother AJ, they were travel team teammates of Justin Blaney.
Oh, okay.
And they got a very famous uncle.
And they had a lot more playing time than my son, and the coach was absolutely right in doing it that way. Dad didn't have any argument.
Their uncle, Ronnie Fields, Kenny, you remember
oh,
him.
Oh, yes. Boy, Ronnie could jump out of a gym.
Hey, you know AJ very, very well. I saw AJ, I want to say he was 11 years old, 12 years old. He had awful cramping in his legs one day, refused to come out of it, absolutely refused to come out.
Yeah, tough.
And I was like, okay, that kid, I remember that and thought this kid's probably down the road going to be a player somewhere, and he certainly was. Miller can't get the roll in, but there to finish it up is Marcus Watson.
Miller took three guys with him to the basket, and that opens up offensive rebounding opportunities. Dribble penetration, the hardest thing to guard, the most effective thing to happen in the half court. All of a sudden, you start playing 4-on-3, 3-on-2.
We're back to zone, guys. Watch.
We're also back to them not moving much.
Front of the iron. I think rebound, and wow, Nick Urban up off the bench because it looked like Justin Harmon was the last to touch, but the officials right there on the corner make the call. It will stay Curie basketball.
I think we're going to go, but they went back to zone. Nick just wanted to switch things up.
Boy, Morgan Park has been so aggressive trying to pick off inbounds passes, and they've gotten several of them. Watson up the floor with 1:38 to go in a four-point Morgan Park lead.
Great move.
How was that move by Roberts?
What a move by Roberts. Again, in transition, that's what they like to do. They like to get up and down the court.
Well, they are scoring in transition. They haven't scored much against set defenses. Neither team, every team, both teams struggled against set defenses.
Hamilton drives and got the roll.
Get that dribble penetration again. Hamilton doing a wonderful job taking everybody to the hoop.
That's Hamilton's first bucket of the night, his first points.
Not a big scorer, but he does so many other things that are effective.
Adam Miller knocks it down from 21 feet.
That's when you look over to the coach and say, I was guarding him.
Yeah.
You know, he's 40 feet away from the basket. I got to guard him out here.
Foul called on the drive to the basket, and that is going to be on Sean Washington, and that is his second. So let's see if Nick Urban goes to the bullpen for Washington.
What I like about that play with Miller, you know, to just clear it out for him, coach, and say, hey, just do what you got to do. You know, whatever you need to do, and he can hit it from half court.
Yeah, I think Nick looked at his bench, said, I ain't making a substitution. We're just going to try and hold for one.
Okay, so that was going to be my next question, Rick. So with 53 seconds to go, you got a bunch of guys all over the place with two fouls. You just go into the front court and just try to get one more shot before the end of the half,
well,
right?
Well, one more unless you get a layup, you know, unless you get a great shot. But I think you do. You're poised here on offense. Spread them out. Try and get something easy. There was a tackle underneath the basket.
Yeah, that was a strange-looking one, wasn't it? 49 seconds left.
Yeah, they're holding for one.
It makes sense because why do I want my guys to play defense one more time in this half when I've got guys out there with two fouls?
Yeah, they just don't want to turn it over.
This guy, you want to have the ball right here. 34 seconds left.
He don't like holding for one.
Boy, you better make that. That's crazy.
Wow.
That is crazy. He does not have a two-point basket tonight. He's got three threes and a couple free throws.
That was big time.
From the corner, three-pointer the other way, and tipped up and in. What a tip by Gordon.
I think number 44 might shoot this again.
I like that call.
Maybe from there.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
I'd run a second. There we go.
He saw it. He got rid of it.
Robert.
That's wide left. And it ends a back and forth opening half. Morgan Park led by 14 in the first quarter. They actually lost the lead for a moment in the second quarter, but they build the lead back up to 7 at halftime. Morgan Park 38, Curie 31, and we're at halftime of the 2019 CPS title game from Chicago State. Back with more in a moment. You're watching the Game of the Week on the YouTube.
And welcome back to Chicago State University. Halftime of our CPS championship game. It's the Mustangs of Morgan Park leading by 7, 38-31 over the Condors of Curie. And welcome back, Mark Kruger, courtside. Glad to have you aboard. You know, you walk into Kenwood Academy, and you're going to come across an English teacher who knew that at a very, very young age he was always going to become a teacher. Our Learning to Win segment is brought to you by our great friends at FinishingChicago.com.
Don't know your claim yet. Don't make it, but you know it in your mind.
I'm Dion Love, an English teacher at Kenwood Academy.
Are we ready to begin? Cool, let's go, please. So typically, I guess I kind of persuade them or manipulate them in a sense to try to get them to do oral presentations. And because I want to break that mentality that they have that they can't write. And so I try to get them to speak first. And from that speaking, then they see how, oh, because I can speak and because I said this, and because this is everything that I would put on paper, I can now transfer that onto paper, and it just connects. I need you to go back within the text using both pieces, both what's written and what you've observed, and I need you to extract evidence to support your position. I grew up with my aunt, and I had to help my aunt get her GED. She didn't finish school. And so it was then in which I realized that she read at a third grade level. And I literally had to help her, piece together words, make sentences, make paragraphs. And I did that while working with her, an adult. And I know that was probably kind of hard for her, but she didn't look at it or take it as any type of humiliation. She actually said, you know, I have someone who can help me. And so she took advantage of that. And so seeing that my aunt could make it through it, I decided that I have a gift, so to say, that I wanted to help other people the same way in which I helped my aunt. All right, pause. Let me get Miss Ashford in here before we go to the next step. Miss Ash. They don't know that I was a bad student when I was in school. I was a really bad student. And it's kind of ironic that I am a teacher.
What helped you, what turned you around from being a bad student to a good student?
I guess me knowing that I wanted change and knowing that I could enact change, but I had to always be on top of my game, that I always had to put my best foot forward and that I always had to succeed at everything that I put my mind to because I didn't want to go back to where I came from, which was nothing, and I wanted to be something.
You have to decide, you have to choose.
I don't think that my students know that I'm teaching them life lessons, but I think in retrospect, they will come to find that I'm teaching them life lessons. However, right now, they think I'm punishing them.
Y'all need to stop. Y'all making me laugh.
It's a family dynamic. What is there not to love about Kenwood Academy? I mean, from the administration, who was very supportive, who ensures that their teachers are equipped with all of the necessary professional development and skills to be able to come into the classroom and teach the students, to the teachers who love what they do, and to the students who just come here every day. I mean, we're a family, we're a community, we're the Kenwood community.
Well, certainly born to be a teacher, no doubt about that. Halftime here at Chicago State University. Morgan Park by 7, 38-31. It's the Game of the Week right here on the YouTube. Welcome back to Chicago State University. Halftime of the CPS Championship game. It's the Mustangs of Morgan Park leading by 7, 38-31. And welcome back. We are joined by Clark Johnson. He is the Director of Marketing for Finishing Chicago. And Clark, always a pleasure to have you with us. Tell us about the services that Finishing Chicago has to offer.
Well, first of all, Mark, thanks for having us on board. We love doing these games. We love the Chicago Public School District Championship. Always fun to do. But what Finishing Chicago is, we're a group of 165 highly trained, highly skilled painting, drywall finishing, wall covering, glazing, sign painting contracts in the Chicagoland area. And Finishing Chicago is a free service to find those contractors. So we actually help you to sort through all the mix of what contractor will fit up with whatever project you have.
That's awesome. Geographically now, do you go all over the Chicagoland area and in the suburbs, or do you service just a specific location?
We have contractors all over the world. So we have wall cover hangers in Dubai right now. But mainly we're in the Chicagoland area. So my area covers Will, Cook, Lake, and Grundy counties, but we can go anywhere, depending on where the project is. So mainly downtown, though.
Now, if someone wants to start a career with Finishing Chicago, what is the process that they have to go through? I know it's a rigorous program.
It's a very rigorous program. So it's a three-year apprenticeship program. You earn while you learn, so it's a great program. So kids who are going to college or maybe they can't afford it or they're looking for other options, it's a great program. But it's 3,200 hours of training in 3 years, 900 hours that's in the classroom. You can, you know, it's a career path though through this training, because you become a superintendent, project manager. A lot of our painters become contractors and instructors in the school. So it's a career path. It's a great way to go.
All right, Clark, thank you so much for stopping by. We appreciate it.
All right, appreciate it. So, hey, we got to go to pdc14apprenticeship.org if you want to find a job, or go to finishingchicago.com and give me a call if you need anything. Thank
Clark
you.
Johnson, thank you for stopping by. Halftime here at Chicago State. Morgan Park by 7, 38-31. Back with more. It's the Game of the Week right here on the YouTube. And welcome back to Chicago State University. The Jesse White Tumbler is always a crowd favorite. We are at halftime of this championship game. Morgan Park leading by 7, 38-31. And I am joined by Carl Kemp. He's the Director of Athletics for the Chicago Public Schools. And Carl, appreciate you stopping by. These two teams, Curie and Morgan Park, really taking two different paths to get to this title game.
Yeah, it's very interesting to see it. On one side, you have Curie. They have a very consistent and constant drive as a team. And then Morgan Park has the kind of like the superstar appeal, right, with Adam Miller. So you have one, all five guys working together, getting there. And then with Morgan Park, you have that one guy that they know they can go to at the end of the ball game to get it done. So it's very interesting with this matchup today.
As far as the teams in this year's field, it's a little different than last year's teams, right? Explain that.
Yeah, so last year you had, you know, big name talents with Taylen Horton, Simeon, Ayo DeSumo with Morgan Park, just a countless others. Orr had Chase Adams and Danny. But this time we kind of had full teams really doing their thing to get their school and their team to this championship. So it's kind of unique, and it kind of speaks to the coaching and then the culture of the schools and the teams.
As far as CPS basketball, I mean, it's some of the best basketball, not only in the state of Illinois, but in the entire country. Would you agree?
Absolutely. And we want to make that known to everybody that's watching. Chicago Public Schools basketball, both boys and girls, top rated. It doesn't get any better than this, and this is just indicative of that today.
Carl Kemp, keep up the great work. We appreciate you stopping by.
Absolutely.
All right, we need to take a break. We'll be back with more. This is the Game of the Week right here on the YouTube.
We are one half away, maybe a little bit more, from deciding a CPS champion, and tonight's game is brought to you by Robert Morris University. Experience makes experts. Experts make a difference. 38-31, Morgan Park leading Curie in the boys' CPS title game. A couple of weeks ago, the girls played their version of the CPS title game. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from Whitney Young's victory over Simeon. 2019 girls CPS championship game, defending champ Simeon against 11-time CPS titleist Whitney Young. Tamia Ware of Whitney Young giving the Dolphins an early lead, but Simeon answering everything. Kanaya Gardner makes the bucket there, tied 40-40 at the half. Second half, Kayla Green of Whitney Young knocks down a three for three of her 12, and then Ware, another three-pointer. Whitney Young started to pull away, but Simeon hung in there late. But in the end, Whitney Young holds off Simeon, winning their 12th CPS title with a 67-64 victory over Simeon. And by the way, Whitney Young getting ready for a section semifinal matchup against Bennett in the girls' state tournament. Our game first half, three-pointers the story early for Morgan Park. Sean Washington with a couple. Adam Miller had three of them. Morgan Park built up a 14-point lead, but in the second quarter, Curie able to come back. They get a three-pointer from the corner from Juwan Gordon, and that tied the game. Curie actually took the lead later on a free throw, but then Morgan Park rallied, and they own a seven-point lead at the halftime as we get ready for what should be an outstanding second half. In fact, if you know anybody,
call them
and tell them to tune in, Kenny, because it should be a barn burner going down the stretch as Curie is going to try and battle back again. My question for you guys is about momentum. Kenny, how hard is it to get a team that rallied from 14 down and now has fallen behind again by seven to keep up the intensity and get the lead again?
You know what? I think the best thing that happened to Curie was halftime, because they had the momentum. They lost it. Morgan Park came back on the streak. So I think that the best thing that happened to the Condors was really halftime. They can re-get that momentum. If I'm Nick, I say, hey, guys, let's keep doing what we were doing at the end of the half, because we were down. We weathered the storm and came back.
And, Rick, we saw Morgan Park just, they were lights out. Forget the offense, the big lead. They were lights out defensively, but they kind of got away from that for a little while and then got it back. So how does Nick Irvin make sure they don't have that defensive lapse they had at the beginning of the second quarter?
Well, you know, I think it was Curie shooting 2 of 13 from 3, normally a much better shooting team. And when Morgan Park is able to clear the boards and run, they're almost unstoppable. Curry's, yes, you know, trying to go to the offensive boards and rebound. But when Morgan Park gets that thing, they're off and running, and they're finishing. And then, you know, Morgan Park, when they had that lead, all of a sudden they started turning the ball over. Turned it over 9 times for 9 points for Curie. And I think that's kind of the deal. Whoever defense shows up for 16 minutes here in the second half is going to be the team that wins.
Little update on the fouls. Justin Harmon, Armand Williams with 2 for Curie. And then for Morgan Park, Chris Roberts, Isaiah Burrell, Carl Jones each have 2. I could have sworn Washington picked up at least 1 foul, but officially in the book, he has no fouls. And he has the basketball right now. He goes to the back door, and Curie able to defend that play, get a stop to open up the second half.
And now can you take advantage of the turnover?
Can you get a score after the stop?
Morgan Park staying in their zone. Curie made a switch and played man-to-man. They had started the game in zone.
Into the corner, drive down the baseline. Gordon
too
able
easy
to go around his man and put it in.
Oh, my goodness, that was too easy.
Way too easy.
You give up the baseline, coach, you're asking for trouble.
And he had 17. That gives him 19 for the game.
Into the lane, a little bump, tough finish. Grover couldn't get it, and a chance to make it a one-possession game for Curie as they have 2 stops now on defense to open up the second half. And now they are within that one possession as Hinton now has 6 points in the game, and it's a 3-point advantage for Morgan Park.
2 easy baskets.
Yeah, and see, halftime stopped the momentum of Morgan Park and gave Curie a chance to regroup.
Wow. There's one-man momentum there.
Are you kidding me?
From the bench. He was on the bench.
And he was guarded. His weight was going away. I mean, that's just a big-time shot.
So what do you say to a player who says, coach, I thought I had him.
I don't think you can let him catch it.
Right.
Baseline jumper that's knocked in by Hinton. So two teams come out red hot here to start the second half. Yeah, Miller could have just kept going and taken a seat over there by Nick Irvin. Boy, he was falling. Miller has it again. They get on top of him that time.
Oh,
Washington, touch pass. Grover couldn't put the right spin on it, but there for the foul was Carl Jones for his first bucket of the night.
But what a pass by Washington.
What a great pass by Washington. He thought a pass ahead. He knew where he was going. Damari Nixon missed the steal and gave up a layup.
Hamilton, corner of the lane, another baseline jumper, and 2 in a row for Hinton.
Hinton's marked that spot. That's the second time he hasn't moved off that spot in the last 2 possessions.
Pressed by the Condors. They were able to get it away. Timeout. Yeah, that was going to be a tough play for Gordon because if he would have slid his keister a little bit, he would have gotten called for a travel.
Yeah, he had nowhere to go, and you see Miller is still on the ground.
Well, at the end of the play, he got hit in the face with the ball.
Yeah, he's okay.
That's Gordon doing it on both ends.
Two in a row for Ramin Hinton of Curie, and it has Curie back within four.
Boy, Coach, you talk about dribble penetration. You drive, you get the defense to come to you, then you dish it over to the open man.
And Hamilton both times getting two assists already here in the second half. Yeah. That's what he does.
7-1, Rick told us earlier, assist to turnover ratio for Trayvon Hamilton.
So you better be ready when he has the basketball, because if you're open, he will find you.
He's a pass first guy, but he can't score. Can't leave him open either.
He does have 3 points in the game.
And we are dancing up a storm here at Chicago State. This big crowd having a lot of fun. Boy, they were late arriving, but look, the upper deck, a lot of people upstairs.
This is a great arena to watch a game.
It really is.
We have seen some unbelievable high school games in this gym over the years. Between CPS title games and super sectional matchups. Yeah. Morgan Park now going to get a little more intense on defense, it looks like.
Yeah, they're extending that zone.
Gordon passed it off in the corner. I'm sorry, guys. Got it back. What a great pass into Gordon. And he now has 21 points in the game.
Morgan Park's got to know where DeJuan Gordon is all the time. You cannot lose him.
2-point lead for Morgan Park, and they have the basketball. Grover, a little bit errant pass, but Watson was able to track it down. They want to get the ball to Miller, and they do.
Well, Gordon's all over Miller.
Miller draws a double, makes his way toward the basket, and that was only a matter of time because Miller was determined to make somebody pay, and the person that pays is Gordon with his second foul.
See, I like that with Miller, though. He had the basketball. He knows he's double teamed. He's going to make something happen. Guys, you're going to foul me. He just decided to attack the basket and said, hey, look, I know you are going to foul me.
That left elbow was sticking out a little, wasn't it?
Maybe a little bit of a chicken wing.
Yeah, Carl Jones picks up his third foul. No activity in the Morgan Park bullpen, though. Oh, no, they do. They get him out of the game. And into the game in his place will go Isaiah Burrell, and he has two fouls. We're just a little north of the midway point of the third quarter. Curie can tie with a two, take a lead with a three. Ooh. Picked off by Kyle Grover, then taken away from him by Damari Nixon. Ball out, last touch by Morgan Park.
One thing I'll say about Miller, he does a great job anticipating being in a passing lane. You see he knocked that ball out of bounds.
Well, there's no excuse. When you're a great passer, there's no excuse to not be a great defender. Because if you're a great passer, you have great anticipation of what's going to happen before it happens. Same thing holds true on the defensive end.
Saved by the Condors, okay. But it went right to Sean Washington. Watson bounce pass. Wide open, Anil Miller, and you can just, oh, wow. That one rattled. I was going to say you can book that, and it rattled out.
I hate giving a shooter a bounce pass.
Why?
I'd much rather catch that ball on a chest pass. If you got an opportunity, you know, sometimes you have to use a bounce pass. That time I think Watson could have gave it to him like a chest pass like that.
Grover will finish. Is it because on a bounce pass, it's not as, with a chest pass, it's going to pretty well get to a player in shooting position.
Yes.
Where a bounce pass, you got to raise or lower it a little bit.
Exactly.
4-point lead for Morgan Park. From the corner.
That wasn't his spot. He's got to move up a couple feet. That's his spot.
Miller looks, and that will be tipped over the backboard and out. Morgan Park will keep it with 3:28 to go.
They just brought Armon Williams Jr. in, and his energy kind of changed the pace in the first half. Let's see what he can bring in the second. Great.
And that was blocked by Gordon.
But Grover did a great job of setting a screen and slipping that coming right to the basket. Curie was going to switch that screen, and Grover didn't let him. He just slipped that screen.
Washington picked up his dribble. So here comes the defensive pressure, and he passed it off to Miller. Miller one-on-one. He's got to eat this up. He'll drive to the basket. He'll put
it in. What body control. He saw the guy taking a charge. He just jumped right to the side.
Right, he makes it look so easy.
Yeah, I mean, he's just so smooth. He's silky smooth. And as Coach said, he just jumped to the side because the defender was about to take a charge and fall down.
That's his first two-point field goal of the night. Beautiful look, but a blocked shot by Sean Washington. Up the floor. Grover had it stripped away. Last touch by Hamilton, so Morgan Park will keep it.
Great hustle by Hamilton because I thought that was a layup. And that's what Morgan Park, that's what they like to do. They like to run down court and see, here's what they want to do. But this is great hustle because this looked like a layup, but Hamilton didn't give up on the play.
Well, he saved him 2 points.
Yes.
Great effort. And that's his job as a point guard, is getting back, stopping that break.
Damari Nixon out, Elijah Pickens in. Miller. And maybe got a little bit too fancy there because Burrell had a guy all over him, and it was Hamilton, and he comes the other way. Hamilton down the lane. He loses the handle. Last touch by the Mustangs.
Boy, Williams was wide open. Boy, if you stop at the free throw line and bounce that to the right side, Williams has the one dribble and a layup. See, Williams is on the right side. Williams is wide open. All you have to do is just bounce it to Williams, then he would have had a layup.
Chris Roberts, who had some outstanding minutes in the first half, into the game from Morgan Park. Baseline.
Charge.
Oh, wow. He will pass it off, and they will call a block on the baseline, and that is on Burrell, and that is his third.
Well, it's the most difficult.
I'm not sure about that call.
The most difficult call to make.
Man, that's a 50-50 call, folks. Yeah. I wouldn't be able to make it.
Well, if I made it, I don't think I would have made it the way they made it.
Guys get their feet set, and they start to lean, you know, and that's, I think, what makes it, for the average person looking at it, to figure out what's going on. That's a beautiful reverse layup by Gordon. Gordon's pouring it on now. He has 23.
Boy, Gordon has a great job of getting to the baseline.
This is Gordon against Miller here for Player of the Year. Whose ever team wins, I can see Mike O'Brien saying, hey, we're just going to give it to that guy.
On the other end of the floor, we get a foul on Hamilton. That is his first. Both teams have committed 2 fouls here in the second half.
Oh,
tipped away.
Ooh.
And now the officials are going to have to do a little work.
Just, you know, just a little contact. No problem, no problem at all. Hinton slipped, thought he was pushed, he slipped.
I think there was a little extracurricular at the end. I think there was a...
Yeah, and then there was a little in-your-face action, too, so... Inbounded to Watson.
In a game like this, there's always going to be something.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of intensity, they're playing for a lot.
Adam Miller, double team, got it to go, and one.
Are you kidding me?
Talking about the ooh and the ah.
He had more than just ooh and ah.
Look at this. This young man can do everything. 1, 2, 3 white shirts, falling back. There's your ooh, and then the ball goes through, and the crowd goes ah.
He is never covered.
It is unbelievable. That is unbelievable.
Miller with 18 points, looking to tack on one more here. By the way, that was the third foul at Armon Williams. I should qualify and say I have him for 3 fouls. That is totally unofficial.
Morgan Park's got to know where Gordon is.
1:40 to go here in the third quarter. Curie with the ball, they're down by 7.
Well, 1-3-1, and Gordon's open on the baseline, but they turned it over.
Washington took it away.
A strong pass here is going to be an advantage.
Roberts. Alley-oop and Burrell with the finish.
Yeah.
Great job by Sean Washington handling the double team, being poised. Once he got out of that double team, it was going to be a layup.
7 Mustangs have now scored in this game. They built the lead back to 9. And we will get a foul. And the guy in the neighborhood was Roberts. And that is who the foul is on. And I have him for 3 fouls now.
You don't want to break up a run if you're Morgan Park by following a shooter like that. You had a nice run going, you had momentum, and all of a sudden these free throws just kind of kill momentum.
Yeah, and then I know they're high school and they're young, but you don't want to foul a guy after he's already shot the ball. The ball's already gone.
Ramin Hamilton in, Armon Williams out. Pickens hit the first free throw.
This is an important minute and 13 right here for both teams. You want to get momentum. Momentum happens at the end of quarters and at the beginning of quarters. They're going to run two at Watson.
Curious, 8 out of 15 from the line tonight. And that one knocked down by Roberts. He has 6.
Great ball movement.
Yeah. Great job by Morgan Park being well-schooled after catching out of double teams, attacking. It was a tough shot.
Yeah, it looked like it might have been a travel, too, but the rebound is pulled down by Hinton. He goes back up with it, and the second time the charm.
Great effort by Hinton.
Hinton with 12, and we're inside of 40 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Up the floor is Watson. Sean Washington.
Great pass.
Beautiful feed. Burrell got hammered.
Great pass. You're not going to be able to double-team Watson when he's looking at the ball. When they're looking at it.
Pickens the foul, we go to Mark Krueger.
Much. Well, there's Robert Smith, the varsity head coach for the Simeon Wolverines. He was here earlier today. His sophomore team repeated as sophomore champions of the CPS. They knocked off Curie this afternoon by a score of 60-47. Fred Poole led the Wolverines in scoring with 19 points. Jim, back to you.
And the Wolverines getting ready to compete in the state tournament. They will be in the toughest sectional to be played at Eisenhower High School.
He finally loses a few games. Nobody's willing to sit next to Rob Smith. Come on.
By the way, that was the first free throw miss by the Morgan Park Mustangs in this game. They had made 7 consecutive prior to that miss to open the game.
And they go back into a zone?
Yeah, it's that 1-3-1. He switched it up after halftime, and this is allowing them to put a little bit more pressure out top.
Oh my.
I think that was blocked on the way, but also a little bit of the body.
Oh, we're getting oohs and ahs on both ends.
I tell you what, Mr. Gordon is something else.
Now, I have that as Carl Jones' 4th foul. And it will send Gordon to the line. He's 3 out of 4 from the line. He's made his last 2 in a row.
Carl Jones has never been able to get in the flow of this game. He's been in foul trouble since the jump.
Thank goodness you had Miller.
Well, 5 seconds to go. I think you're going to get the ball to Miller. He's going to have to break through a double team. See what happens. But if you're Curry, you cannot let Miller catch the ball right here. I think you just face guard him.
If he gets to the Jumpman logo, he's in range.
I think once he enters the building, he's in range.
Yep, one of those guys is in range as soon as he steps off the bus. Second free throw rattles in and out. 3 seconds left. They try to get it to Miller. They do. Sees the clock. That counts if it goes. A little bit too much club.
He's got to work on that.
Yeah, that's the only thing in this game that isn't absolutely 100% spot on. End of 3 quarters in the CPS Boys Championship game. Morgan Park 55, Curie 47. You're watching the game of the week on the U2. Tonight's game is being brought to you by the contractors of finishingchicago.com. Just about set for the fourth quarter. 55-47 Morgan Park leads. And it is my honor to be joined at halftime by the CEO of the Chicago Public Schools, Janice Jackson. Janice, we decided a long time ago in this country that in addition to the academics, the arts and athletics were also an important part of the educational experience. So tell me how the arts, academics, and athletics all fit together in CPS.
Well, you know, Chicago Public Schools is a district on the rise, and for many years, we've been trying to make sure there's a healthy integration between a high-quality education, but also making sure it's well-rounded and that we're educating the whole child. And that means access to the arts. That means an outlet for healthy activity through sports and an opportunity to learn and grow and express yourself in multiple ways. So I see this as a way for students to not only develop life skills that will help them no matter what career they choose, but it also gives them an opportunity to interact in a healthy manner with their peers.
Now, so much, and I think a little bit too much emphasis, and this goes for everybody, is on a scholarship through athletics. athletics.
Yeah.
But athletics also, it teaches critical collaboration skills as well, and that's why athletics in particular is important to the overall education experience, right?
Well, let me make a couple of connections. So we've talked a lot about the dramatic academic progress that's happened in CPS. One of the other things that has happened as a result is more and more of our kids are getting scholarships because they're more qualified, but they also are high need. So we have students, last year we got over $1.3 billion in scholarship opportunities for our kids, and some of those were for sports, but many of them were for merit and other opportunities. For me, I'm always trying to spread the message that athletic scholarships are important, but I want more students, in particular African-American students, to think about non-traditional sports as well, because there are a lot of opportunities in areas like tennis and volleyball, some of the things that we don't naturally think about. Basketball is great. We're here today celebrating two of our best teams here in Chicago, but my job is to make sure kids know that they have so many additional opportunities out there, and that's what we're working on in the district.
Describe for me the challenge that exists now in education because of technology.
Oh, yeah.
And it is part of something that students are going to have to deal with when they get to the workplace. Mm-hmm. So how, from a curriculum standpoint, do you make sure that the students are getting the 21st century skills they need to succeed in the workplace when school is done?
Technology is a huge lever. And, Jim, it's very different than when we went to school when they rolled out the computers as a special event. My daughter was using a computer when she was 2 years old. So now when students enter CPS schools, they're in classrooms using technology as early as three.
The computer lab is going away,
isn't it? The computer lab is every day.
Janice, thank you so much for joining us here at halftime and continued success to everybody in CPS.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Janice Jackson, the CEO of Chicago Public Schools, joining us here between the third and fourth quarters. And as we open the fourth quarter, we get a three-pointer from Gordon to open and then a turnover by Morgan Park. So here we are, five-point margin. For Morgan Park, Curie has the basketball.
Well, Curie doing a good job to start this quarter, Jim, and that turnover, can they capitalize?
And make it a one-possession game they do as it's knocked in by Harmon.
This is the same way the second quarter started.
What a time for Harmon to get his first bucket of the night. Watson trying to get around Hamilton. Oh, and the Curie Condors a couple of times almost picked it off. Adam Miller, top of the key, couldn't hit. And a foul underneath. It is going to be on the Curie Condors.
Great effort by Grover going to the rim to try and get a second shot there.
Hamilton picks up the foul, his second.
Yeah, see, what Hamilton is saying, I was boxing him out. But you see, his back is true, so they're back-to-back. I see how he's clearing them out back-to-back.
Well, the Condors take it away in the inbound pass. Up the floor.
Oh.
Missed dunk, but a foul by Gordon.
I love that by Gordon, though. You play the, you'll play the play all the way through.
One-point lead for Morgan Park. Nick Urban wants a timeout.
And the fans are into it now.
Wow. Listen to this crowd.
Both teams have withstood some punches to the face here. Both teams have went on runs. Let's see if Morgan Park can respond.
Well, it is a pretty typical battle in the Chicago Public League.
And how important is Public League basketball? Is it NBA All-Star break? There are three NBA referees here, which is pretty impressive. But look at the last bucket, Coach. You missed the dunk. But say, this is what I like so much about Gordon. He plays it all the way through. He didn't stand there anticipating the dunk was going to happen. Well, he saw Harmon misses the dunk, but he played it all the way through.
There's so much to like about Gordon.
Yeah, well, it's so easy to just stand back and say, okay, we have a dunk. He played the entire play through.
He's played this entire game through.
Yes.
The biggest lead in this game for Curie is 1 point. They have the ball now. They're down by one. 3-pointer would obviously give them their biggest lead of the game. They only have 3 3-pointers in the game, and they're all by Gordon.
Boy, they're really getting into it now.
Well, when you look at Player of the Year in the Chicagoland area, you really got to look at this DeJuan Gordon, because he he scores when they need him to score points. He's not scoring. They're not keeping him in a lot at the end of games. I think he got fouled.
He has 29 in the game. Condors up the
maybe
floor.
31 if he gets this up.
Gordon, he was tied up by Burrell for a moment and then turned it over. Boy, the crowd is just deafening in here right now. A little push-up shot. Adam Miller, you just get to a point where you're not surprised by anything going on out of his head.
What, this is Miller versus Gordon. This is going to turn out to be Ali versus Frazier.
Yeah, this is a heavyweight battle, that's for sure.
Nicholas versus Watson for some of us who play other sports. Three-pointer on the way. That one was short, and Burrell got the rebound, but then it got out of his hand and fell out of bounds.
You know, I was in New York a couple of weeks ago, and I went to the Garden to watch the Knicks play for some reason.
I hope they gave you the ticket.
They did. But there's pictures all over the Garden of Ali versus Frazier.
Taken by Sinatra.
Yes.
Sinatra was a photographer for that fight.
Yep.
That's an expensive photographer.
Fouls on Marcus Watson. That is his second. That is team foul number 6 on Morgan Park. So the next foul by Morgan Park, Curie goes to the bonus, but they have struggled from the free throw line tonight. Three-pointer ties it. That's for the tie. Little wide left. Big rebound by Kyle Grover.
Grover does all the intangible things.
He really does, doesn't he?
He just adds a level of toughness that you don't see often in a high school player.
Miller drives, hangs, and got the roll.
Are you absolutely kidding me?
I tell you, I mean, how do you stop him?
23 points and back to a 5-point lead for Morgan Park.
I give the ball to Gordon.
You're a good coach, Ken.
Hamilton shovels it off. He'll get an assist on the finish by Harmon.
And Hamilton, most of the time in the half court, is getting assists. He's breaking people down. He's just a great quarterback to have on the team.
I hear Hamilton's a really big deal these days.
I think so.
That'll be a foul on Damari Nixon. His second. And that
we
is...
We are going to be shooting from here on out both
ways.
That's
team foul number 6. Both teams with 6 team fouls, so... And Morgan Park has really been good from the foul line. They're 7 out of 8.
Yeah, they haven't gotten there as many times as Curie has, but when they got there,
yeah, that's
going to
be
get there now.
Yeah, that's going to be Gordon, and that's going to be his third. He got all tangled up with Adam Miller, and now Miller gets a chance to go to the line. Miller tonight from the free throw line, 3 of 3.
Well, if you're Curie, you're looking to deny Miller the ball, but you can't hold him. And I'm not sure he did.
Yeah, a lot of contact.
Got him at the end.
But that's almost, I don't want to jinx him, but it's almost like putting 2 points on the board.
Well, we'll tell the story again, Kenny. First time that we called a game with Adam Miller at Glenbart East.
Come on, let's not go there.
What did he have, 45?
You know what, let's not go there. Can we talk about something else? Oh. You guys have done a lot of games together.
Wow, he's human. He missed one.
Well, his second missed free throw.
All right, now I just look for Gordon.
4-point lead for Morgan Park. Curie with the basketball. Nearly taken away, and that won't go.
Big
Tough rebound for Burrell. He's been good on the boards tonight.
He's giving him a big lift with Jones in foul trouble.
Miller has it. He'll get rid of it. Watson, Washington open for a three. That's short all the way. And, wow, I thought that was off Miller. Instead, they rule the ball was last touched by Harmon.
I think that Morgan Park knew it was off Harmon. Can you see Miller just let it go out of bounds? Let's hit
that,
again.
That didn't come off of Sean Washington's hands right. Just didn't look right coming out.
You see Miller just
but he sold it. You know, half the time, refs look to see how players react and make their calls after that.
Yeah, I think that was clearly off Harmon, so no doubt about that one.
Five seconds.
A 5-second call. Curie will get it back. They're down by 4 with 4:15 to go. We have a chance of having an unbelievable finish here. Williams goes out of the game. Hinton comes back in for Curie.
I don't think there's any question this is going to come down to a last-second shot.
Back and forth we go. Off the switch. Great nice pass. Feed on the baseline. And we get a foul called on the floor on Morgan Park. They are lobbying. Foul is on Watson. That is his third, according to my scorekeeping. Hinton on the line. He's 0 for 2. Picked a good time to break the goose egg.
Yeah, you jinxed them in the right way that time.
Yeah. All right, so we get Chris Roberts back into the game for Morgan Park. He will replace Kyle Grover.
Gives Morgan Park a little bit more offense.
Boy, Roberts has been good in the minutes he's been out there tonight.
He might be one of the fastest kids in the public league end-to-end with the basketball.
So Hinton comes in clutch. He hits both free throws, and it's a two-point Morgan Park lead, 4:02 to go. Full court from Curie. Now they back off the inbounder. Sean Washington, he's been relatively quiet the last little bit here.
Boy, look at Williams doing a great job on Miller.
Miller, ooh, threw it away. Curie with a chance to tie it with a two, take the lead with a three.
Williams did a great job, though, making Miller work real hard for the basketball. And I think Miller was frustrated just trying to get the ball out of his hands and threw it away.
Carl Jones back into the game. He has four fouls.
He hasn't been able to stay in the game more than a minute at a time, but he can really make things different at the rim.
Well, Kenny, your analogy was right. This is a heavyweight bout now, going back and forth, blow for blow. Hamilton threw it into the corner. Damari Nixon. Hamilton, Drew Jones, then passed off. Jump stop by Damari Nixon, couldn't hit, rebound. Let me check that, the shot was by Gordon. We get a foul. Jones was in the neighborhood.
Well, you take Grover out of the game, that hurts you a little bit on the defensive boards. Curie does a good job of penetrating. Again, drawing two guys to him, it opens up offensive rebounds.
That was on Washington. Harmon on the line, he's 1 out of 2.
Harmon did a great job going to the boards.
That has been the chink in the armor tonight for Curie as their free throw shooting.
Yeah, we talked about that early in the ball game, that free throw shooting can always come back to haunt you in a close game in the fourth quarter.
Morgan Park has not had a lot of easy baskets since the fourth quarter started. Everything's been a struggle. A couple circus shots from the All-American Adam Miller, but other than that, they haven't really been able to get into a flow.
1 point lead for Morgan Park. They have the basketball. Miller lost it for a moment, went back and got it. He gets a double team. Great catch by Washington. He threw it to Hamilton. Curie with a chance to take the lead. Inside, off glass, Gordon couldn't hit. Rebound by Roberts. He had it taken away by Harmon. Curie's got a reset. Hamilton does the job.
Timeout, Curie. Mike Oliver wanted to calm things down.
We are going to make an early call on players of the game because it's really pretty obvious, folks.
Finishing, you don't have to Chicago, be a brain surgeon for this, yeah, one.
FinishingChicago.com brings it to you. Adam Miller, 24 points and still a ways to go.
Need something else.
It's been the timing of his baskets, though, that's really been critical.
He might need 30 to make Morgan Park pull out a victory here tonight.
Dejuan Gordon for Curie. 29 points. He's our player of the game for the Condors.
He's not used to playing four quarters. Curry's won so many games by so many points. He's not used to playing this many minutes.
And those are our players of the game. And for one last time, brought to you by our good friends at FinishingChicago.com. And thanks to FinishingChicago.com for being with us all season long here on the YouTube Game of the Week.
And that's just what it's going to take, somebody to finish up in Chicago. It's a great sponsor, great name for what we got going.
Somebody
here.
Somebody with some drywall finishing skills, Rick.
Let's go. Somebody's going to be a finisher here. Who's it going to be? Maybe it's going to be somebody that hasn't even hit a basket all day, and they're going to hit a big shot at the end here.
Morgan Park trying to win their first CPS title since 2010. Curie trying to win their first CPS title.
Boy, I tell you what, it's going to be very, very good.
Jim Blaney along with Kenny McReynolds, Rick Malnati, Mark Kruger, our finale for the year, and it is setting up to be a classic. The last time Morgan Park won the CPS title, they won it on a last possession bucket by Wayne Blackshear. Will we have that type of finish again? And as I mentioned, that was back in 2010 at the UIC Pavilion. I remember it well. I have it in my own personal archive.
Oh, great hands by Grover.
Burrell came up with it. Morgan Park with the ball, 2.5 to go. Washington holds out a hand to Watson and says, just walk it up.
Yep, take your time, be smart.
We have a collision at the top of the key. That's going to be on Burrell. That's his fourth.
Yeah.
He stuck out his hip, guys.
I got to see it. I don't know.
Let's get this out of the way. Tonight's game being directed by Frank Vance, the technical director, John Ott. Associate producer for the game of the week is Jake Christ. Instant replay by Sean Brown. Stats tonight, Tim McKinney. Rebecca Galloway is the assistant, the executive producer. Production services provided by Chef Tech. And, of course, our fearless leader in EP is Fred Weintraub. And we have a whistle before the shot. No shot.
Burrell took a charge. Oh, wow.
That is going to be on Hamilton, his third.
Every possession is critical right now.
Right now, yes.
Armon Williams into the game. Ramin Hinton is out.
Yeah, I think that's for, that has to be for defense because he's done a great job on the defensive end all day.
2:11 to go. Curie full court pressure on the inbound. Washington had a little bit of trouble getting it in. Now Watson will bring it into the front court. Two minutes to go. Morgan Park with the ball. They lead it by one.
Every time he touches the ball, they're running two at him.
Watson off of the screen. Couldn't get free. Picked up a double team.
Timeout.
Nick Irvin before Watson lost the basketball.
That saved a turnover.
That saved a turnover.
Because he just lost the basketball. Nobody touched him. He just dribbled the ball off
Watson
of his leg.
Should be hugging Nick instead of Nick hugging Watson.
Yeah. Right.
Murray does a great job moving his feet.
Well, look at this. Right off of his knee. Yeah.
Look at Watson looking over the bench. Yep. All good. Coach called timeout.
And then he's going to hug me. Well, you got to run your best play right now if you're Morgan Park. And it might not be. It might be using Miller as a little bit of a decoy. Get him the ball in the middle of the court where he gets double teamed and he can pass out of it and make something happen for one of his teammates.
And Curie has not had the lead in the second half of this game. They led it early, and they led it early, or they led it in the second quarter after they won on their run. They have fought back and they have been close, but they have not been able to get over the hump. Morgan Park, by the way, their biggest lead of the game was 14.
Well, this has been a complete game of runs. Basketball is always a momentum game, but today these runs have been, you know, 8 and 10 point runs.
And the game has been everything we thought it would be.
Winner of this game replaces Orr as CPS champions.
The question may be, will four quarters be enough?
I was just thinking about that.
To settle this heavyweight bout.
I think it's going to be somebody's going to have to make a free throw. Somebody's going to have to shoot a three in.
Washington will inbound for Morgan Park.
Pretty capable hands in Watson's hands.
Watson for Grover. Now they get it to Adam Miller. Miller double teamed. He passed out of it.
Yeah, Miller could catch the ball at the top of the key and get double-teamed. Something's going to open up.
Now you Washington.
You can't take the basket out. I know they're holding for one, but you still have to attack the basket. Bad things happen when you just hold.
Washington trapped on the sideline, got away from it. Adam Miller fires it. Runner by Watson, traveling. Yeah, Curie basketball, 108 to go.
Yeah, that's the right call.
Well, this could be Curry's first lead in the second half right now.
Well, I think I just called for my start right here.
Well, Gordon's got to touch it.
He is in the corner at the top of your screen now.
Being guarded by Miller.
To Gordon's side. Dropped it off. Inside Gordon, and Curie leads by one. 50 seconds to go.
Do we have Miller time, Kenny?
Miller
stolen by Nixon.
Up the floor. Herman. Curie gets an and one.
Big defensive play by Damari Nixon making the steal, and then Herman finishing. This is a big free throw.
Oh, the huge free throw. I don't know about Miller time, but we certainly have a Herman time.
Foul was on Marcus Watson, and that is his fourth. Three players from Morgan Park, by our count, have four fouls. That is certainly an issue if we do go to overtime.
I think Watson fouled out.
Did he foul out? Yes.
Yes, he did. So Watson's out of the game.
Well, this is a crucial free throw because this will make it two possessions.
Harmon is 2 of 4 from the line. He made his last free throw. Four-point lead, 40 seconds to go. Morgan Park basketball, Adam Miller has it.
Don't foul him.
Offensive foul on Miller.
My. Nick Irvin's on the middle of the floor. Did he call timeout? Is there a timeout?
He's calling a timeout.
Technical foul.
On who?
Okay, we have Grover and Washington talking to the officials.
Don't celebrate with your parents yet.
I think one ref didn't know a timeout was called.
Right.
Saw Nick Irvin in the middle of the court, gave him a T.
And Michael Oliver is saying, hey, wait a minute, you called a technical.
Right.
Yeah, but I think you're right. One coach didn't know that Nick wanted a timeout. But talk about an instant classic.
The officials are telling Michael Oliver to go back to his huddle. They will discuss, because if it's a technical, that's critical because it's the shots and possession.
Well, if it's a technical, this game's over.
Yeah, but the question is, if Nick had called a timeout,
he could come on the court.
He could come on the court.
Right.
Yeah. So
we got to get a clarification.
Yeah.
They're just pointing over to the Mark Kruger is right over there listening in, so Mark will give us the story here. And
I don't think they called the technical.
I don't think they did either.
Yeah. I think it's going to be Curry's ball. Morgan Park has to make a play defensively or put him on the free throw line.
Yeah, I think Nick had called the timeout, and one official, you're right, coach, didn't know it.
Morgan Park has 10 team fouls, so Curie is in the double bonus.
That's big. You're a lot more comfortable going to the free throw line.
Let's go to Mark Kruger. Mark, what do you got for us?
Well, Jim, one of the officials came over to the official scorers at the table. He said there is no technical, simply a timeout taken by Curie, Jim.
Kenny, do you have a little more for us?
Yeah, Marvin, the official, said that Curie had called the timeout, and one official didn't know it, so this is why he called the tech on Morgan Park, but they wipe it out because other timeout was given. You were right, coach. One official didn't know it.
Yep.
So here we go. Curie with the ball, leading by 4. 37 seconds to go. This is their biggest lead of the game, by the way. In the backcourt, Grover.
Uh-oh. Don't want to pick it up there.
They pass it off. Hamilton was not fouled by Burrell.
They got a foul.
Hamilton got
foul.
Away
Too
from Miller.
Time.
Hamilton gets fouled with 23.5 left. Hamilton is 1 out of 3 from the foul line. He made his last free throw.
All right, I'll tell you what, Hamilton's had a pretty good ball game.
Well, Hamilton's had a great ball game.
Yeah, Hamilton has really, really stepped up. I can't say enough about Williams on the defensive end. And, of course, Gordon has just been outstanding.
Yeah.
I believe the foul might have been on Adam Miller.
Well, the game's still not over.
No.
Oh, no.
You really have to make two of them to put Morgan Park in a bad spot, and he misses the first. This is a big one, because if you miss this one, Morgan Park doesn't need to take a three at all. They'll only be down four.
I think they take whatever is easiest here. They drive it hard to the basket. Losing Watson's big for Morgan Park. Roberts might have to get the ball and take it real quick to the rim.
Hamilton made the second. That actually helps Morgan Park because the clock doesn't start until the ball comes in. Washington has it. Wants to get it to Miller, I would think. Washington will drive. He'll hang. Can't hit. Offensive foul on Sean Washington.
Every call has went against Morgan Park in the last minute and a half.
Yeah. So now if you're Curie,
now it's over.
You just hold the ball, be smart.
Well, look at Morgan Park. They're not even up pressing. Morgan Park's conceded the game.
Use your full 10 to get it across the timeline.
They just stopped. It's over.
Look at Nick. He's trying to get a technical.
Hamilton watching the clock. There's all sorts of people on the floor. The game is now over. The Curie Condors, they only led in this game for a total of maybe 45 seconds. But for the first time in school history, the Curie Condors will have a CPS championship trophy in their cabinet, and they win it over Morgan Park, 65-60.
Congratulations to Coach Oliver. Well deserved. He's had an unbelievable year, and as you guys said at the beginning, they have been under the radar for a team that hasn't lost in the state of Illinois, run the table 29-1, city champs, and you really don't hear about them.
And he is such a wonderful person.
Yeah.
He is a great guy. You have to be happy for Coach.
Curie trailed by as many as 14 in the first half before fighting and clawing their way back in getting a victory today. So our final, Curie 65, Morgan Park 60, for the final time this year. I'm Jim Blaney. For Rick Malnati, Kenny McReynolds, Mark Kruger, our entire U2 Sports crew, been a great season. Congratulations to the Curie Condors, 2019 CPS champions.